She here in the NICB with Dr. Dennis Collins, who spoke earlier. So today I'm going to be talking about immunotherapy in breast cancer. So immunotherapy, the basis of it is using the patient's immune system to fight their cancer. So immunotherapy has become a huge hot topic in cancer research at the moment. There's been huge successes in melanoma and lung cancer, and now they're trying to see whether this will translate to many different cancer types. So as I said, I'm going to look at it in breast cancer, and the main there's a couple of different types of immunotherapy, and the main immunotherapy I'm going to talk about today is immune checkpoint inhibitors. So your immune cells are circulating around your body. They're recognizing any irregular cells and are destroying them. However, when a cancer develops, it can upregulate a protein on its surface called an immune checkpoint. And when the immune cell is circulating and recognizes the cancer cell and binds, if the immune checkpoint is expressed, the immune cell gets turned off and it isn't able to destroy the cancer cell. However, if we add an immunotherapy into this, it blocks the immune checkpoint, and when the immune cell comes, it can recognize the cancer cell, remain active, and destroy the cancer cell. So as has already been discussed, there are certain drugs, antibody therapies, that already use the immune system to fight cancer cells. So an example of this is Herceptin. So how Herceptin works, as previously discussed, is that it binds to the cancer cell, can recruit an immune cell, the immune cell then releases granules, which can destroy the cancer cell. However, if the immune system is suppressed, Herceptin may not be as effective, and combining immunotherapy with this may help it become more effective. So in order to investigate whether this is the case, we have to examine this in the lab first. So for this, I need immune cells, cancer cells, and the drugs. And in order to get the immune cells, we get them from blood samples. So we put out a call about a month or two ago now, looking for healthy volunteers in DCU to donate blood samples. And we also have some patients that we can get blood samples from as well. And we can isolate out the immune cells from these blood samples based on the fact that immune cells are of a different density than other cells present in the blood. So here on the left we can see healthy volunteer cells that I isolated from a volunteer, and we can see that they're nice uniform kind of range circles. However, this is unlikely to be the case in a patient. They're more likely to be active immune cells that are fighting an ongoing insult, and they're more likely to be maybe suppressed as well. So in order to make it kind of a more relevant model, I cultured these cells and treated them. And here we can see that they've kind of grown into different shapes, and there's a clump there on the right where they're dividing, and they've become more of a model of what might be happening in the patient. So then going forward, we need our cancer cells, which we grow in the lab in flasks. And we add our cancer cells, our immune cells, and our drug in together, and we incubate them for a desired amount of time, which is usually about 12 hours. And over this time period then, the immune cells are destroying the cancer cells. We then add our viability dye, so this allows me to differentiate between alive and dead cells. So then in the end, we have a mixture of live immune cells, dead immune cells, live cancer cells, and dead cancer cells. And then I can quantify how effective a treatment is based on how many dead cancer cells there are. So in conclusion, I'm trying to use healthy volunteer and breast cancer patient blood samples to measure how effective immune-related breast cancer treatments are. So I'd just like to thank my healthy volunteers as well that have given me blood.